Hey guys, and welcome to my top 10 animes. So these are the top 10 animes in my opinion, okay guys, in my opinion, and it's overall, so it's really difficult to say which one is better than the other one, and I had to leave out a lot of good animes to make this. But hey, this is my opinion and I hope you agree in some degree. But hey, if you don't, that's fine, we can have different opinions. But let's get down to it. There are lots of different genres, and some are horror, some are comedy, funny, and all that kind of stuff. So they're very different. So I don't think you agree completely with me, but hey, enjoy. First off, at spot number 10, we have Full Metal Alchemist. This anime is a bit overrated in my opinion. It was said to be one of the best animes, and I don't really think that. But it's an adventure science fantasy genre. There's a lot of brotherhood in it, which is good, and the main character is kind of badass, and he's special and skillful. And he's with his brother, who's the more quiet type. Not so adult-like, he's more like a child. And hey, it's a great anime, not the best in my opinion, but it's great, so be sure to watch it. In spot number 9 we have The Familiar of Zero, also known as Zero no Tsukaima or something. Be sure to correct me if I'm pronouncing it wrong. But hey, it's an adventure fantasy harem romantic comedy, and I think it's really, really funny. And I know what you think, you're a pervert, it's a harem, but hey, it's not only a harem, there's more to it than that. It's about magic and a guy from our world going to another world where magic exists. And it's a really funny, funny anime. I recommend it. The next one I have for you in spot number 8 is High School DxD. And it's an action fantasy harem. And yeah, again, harem, what a fucking pervert I am, I know, but hey, you can't not fall in love with these girls. They are so sweet, so, so sweet, one for each taste, and they're really pretty. I mean, amazing draw work there. And the main character is not your typical badass guy. He's actually, he's not quite popular amongst the girls. But hey, he's a really funny good guy. Kind of a perverted high school student. And it's not only that, it's fallen angels versus devils. So there's a bit plot to it there. At my number 7, I put an anime called Elfin Lied, or Elfin Lied, I'm not sure about that, but it's a psychological horror romance science fantasy. And I know, horror? Romance? What? But hey, they go together very well in this one. I was really surprised when I saw it. There's a girl, and she's both cute and scary at the same time. It gave me a little bit of the feels, not much, but a little bit. So hey, it's a great anime, and it's about this guy who finds this girl, and she is something else than they think she is in the beginning. And it turns out that some are after this girl, and yeah, you can see the rest for yourself, no spoilers, you know. So yeah, I recommend this one as well, it's really good, and that's why it's in my spot number 7. So, number 6 is not your typical today anime. This one is actually pretty old. And this was one of the first animes that I ever watched. I think it's good. It's really good. And it's a martial arts romantic comedy urban fantasy. It's about this guy who, when poured water upon him, he turns into a girl. And yeah, he has been promised married to a girl, and she's not really happy about the fact that he half the time is a girl. So yeah, it's, as you probably guessed, there are a lot of funny moments in this this anime, even though it's old. But hey, it was one of my childhood animes, and I enjoyed it very much when I read it the first time. I actually recommend reading this one. It's a bit long if you have to watch it, but if you're gonna watch it, it will take you some time. But hey, let's go on to the next one. So this one is Attack on Titan, and yeah, you might be thinking, hey, why is that not up? This should be at least number three, but I really couldn't, guys. I've seen a lot of good animes, and this one is not done yet. Maybe when season 2 or 3 or 5 or so on comes out, you know, then it will be higher in my opinion. But there's only one season now, and I want to see more. It has great potential, this one, and it's a dark fantasy post-apocalyptic. And, well, fuck, I've almost never heard of those genres before, and that's why this one's so cool. Like, it's fighting with giants, and yeah, really emotional. I think there's a lot of emotions in Attack on Titan. And yeah, the brother, sister, yeah, it's complicated in there, but hey, it's a really good anime. I don't have so much word for it, but hey, one season, I would maybe recommend waiting a year or two to watch it, because then there would be more to come for. But yeah, it's a good anime, and I look forward to the next season. I know that. At my spot number 4, we have High School of the Dead. And yeah, if it wasn't for the missing next season, which I've been waiting for so freaking long now, yeah, maybe it would have been higher up as well. But it's a horror harem, and it's about, well, fucking zombies. Zombies everywhere. And badass girls and a badass guy. Two badass guys, actually, where one of them is, besides being pretty weird and stuff, actually really funny. And the other one is the basic leader, you know, motivates the rest of the group and takes action whenever needed to. And then there are these three or four really cool girls, which kick some serious ass. But yeah, it's a good anime. Zombies, hot girls, yeah, it has almost everything that should be in a harem. So yeah, I recommend this as well. This is a really good one. If you haven't seen it, it's really quick to see, so you can get past it really quickly. So yeah, I could recommend it. Finally, it comes down to the last three, and my number three is Sword Art Online. I think this one is freaking awesome. Like, the storyline in this is amazing, but halfway through season one there comes a bit of a plot twist, and I think that's very it actually sucks in some way. But the first a couple of episodes are so amazing, really amazing, and I've almost never seen an anime this good, so I really think you should see it. It's action adventure drama, and it's about this guy who goes into an MMORPG. And it's virtual reality, so he's like in there in person, which is I hope the next thing in gaming in real life as well. And it's funny to see it in like an anime. Yeah, and there are actually some romance stuff in here as well. I'm not sure why it's not in these genres, but yeah, hey, watch it for yourself. It's awesome. It got me so hooked in so little time. So yeah, go watch it for yourself. Yeah, and my number two, it's Naruto. Yeah, ninjas, fucking ninjas. And this was also one of the first animes I ever followed, and yeah, I've just been stuck with this till this moment. It's not really, I heard a little bird singing about the ending was near, and I've been following it since almost day one. But yeah, I'm definitely going to read this one to the end. It's awesome, there's lots of action. It's an action-adventure fantasy, actually. I'm not sure if martial arts should be included in there, but hey, it's ninja, so maybe that's why. But yeah, lots of episode. I maybe recommend reading if you don't have the time for watching the anime. The anime can take a really, really long time. And yeah, there are a little bit of romance, but not much. But yeah, it's just about fighting and friendship and being awesome awesome fight. Yeah, it almost got everything. So guys, I am really sorry about this, but I really didn't know what to do. I had no clue what to freaking do. Since this is an overall rating of all animes I've ever watched, I just couldn't pick one number one. So I had to choose three different, alright? And one of them is Future Diary, also called Mirai Nikki. This is an action science fiction suspense, and it is so jaw-dropping good. I can't explain it. This made me cry several times, and I don't cry usually. So, yeah, it's pretty fucking intense in there. This is probably what I would recommend the most for a new anime watchers who's following, because it's for everybody, and it has great storyline, great character build, great drawings. The girl in there, I don't know what the fuck to think about her, but she's got me on the hook. This freaked me out so much, and one of my friends watched it almost the same time as I did. He was hooked just as much as me, so I really, really recommend this. This is a 10 out of 10 for me. And another 10 out of 10 for me is One Piece. Yeah, it's another freaking action adventure fantasy. I know, I'm sorry, but this one, just as Naruto, I followed this since my childhood. I think it's a bit over Naruto. I like the character build a little more, and brotherhood in here, friendship and holding together. It's amazing. It's really, really amazing. And yeah, I would recommend reading this one instead of seeing it as well. It's so long, guys. But hey, it's awesome. I enjoyed every bit of it. Like, there are devil fruits where you gain power, but then you can't swim and all. It's a great build-up. So yeah, it's this guy who has a dream, who assembles a pack of people called his crew, who also has different kind of dreams, and they all want to go in and accomplish these dreams together, and they end up loving each other, everyone. And yeah, it's amazing. I'm so speechless. Go watch it for yourself, guys. It's awesome. I can't say this enough. It's awesome. So guys, it comes down to the last of the three I've chosen, and it is of course Dragon Ball. Everybody loves Dragon Balls. I've never met a person who didn't. And this is like the grandfather of a lot of different animes, and it is great. It has everything, loving characters, and awesome fight scenes again. And the fight scenes, they're amazing. But yeah, if you want to watch the anime, be prepared to like watch them speak to each other for like 5 or 10 minutes in between the fights and stuff, where they really don't do much. But yeah, I read it. It doesn't take as long. It's awesome. They kind of level up in a weird way. And some of them are from outer space, another planet and stuff. So yeah, there's a bit of alien there. But it's an action adventure comedy, martial arts, science fantasy. And yeah, this was probably the first anime I've ever read in my entire life. So this was the one, guys. This was the one. This took my virginity. So I also rate this 10 out of 10. The last three was 10 out of 10. But yeah, the other animes I put in here as well are very good as well. As I've said in the beginning, these 10 animes are those I think are the best. But then there are so many animes, and I can't make a complete list. I can't see all of them, even though I try. I try very hard. So yeah, if you have any suggestions for me to watch, be sure to leave them here, because I definitely love anime and use a lot of time watching it. So yeah, I think you should watch every single one of those I put in here. And if you want to, like, if you watched all of them and don't have a clue on what to watch next, then please write a message to me. I have more animes for you to watch. Some of them are dirty, some of them fighting, and so on and so on. Not hentai though, guys. stay away from hentai. It can get weird. Very weird. Yeah, so I think that's all for me. Thank you guys for watching. Please leave a like and oops. Please leave a like if you like the video, and if you want to see more, be sure to check out the rest of my channel and subscribe. So, arigato for watching. See you next time.